Good afternoon, good afternoon. Thank you for coming on. Good afternoon. Good afternoon. This is a quick thought. I'm going to be brief. I'm going to be extremely brief, extremely brief. In the book of Genesis, in the book of Genesis with Adam, the Bible says that after God had created Adam, and then God had created the God created the all the fishes of the sea. And God had created all the fowls of the air. And the Bible says that after God had created everything, the creatures in the sea and in the air, the Bible says that God brought everything to Adam to see what he would call it. And see, I come to tell you today that some of you, just like if I could give an example, just like with Moses, when Moses was at the Red Sea and he couldn't go no farther with the children of Israel, and the Israelites and the Egyptians were behind them in high pursuit, and Moses turned to God for help, and God looked at Moses and asked Moses, "What is in your hand?" Listen to me closely. Your move. There's some of you, you've been praying for a certain thing. You've been believing for a certain thing, and you're waiting on God to answer. You're waiting on God to move. You're waiting on God to intervene in your particular situation. But I come to tell you that God told me to tell you what's in your mouth. It's what's in your mouth. God told me to tell you to title it. See, many of you, you're looking for a new job and you're waiting on the new job, but you hadn't given it a name. God wants you to give it a name. Some of you, you want to come out of your situation. Your answer is in your mouth. Your answer is in your mouth. Many of you is looking for a new love. Your answer is in your mouth. For the Bible says to call those things that be not as though they were. In other words, when you decree it, when you speak it, God is going to hasten to perform it. And see, you've been waiting on God, but God been waiting on you. And I come to tell you today that God told me to tell you to give it a name. Give it a name. So many of you are waiting on a healing. You've been believing God to be healed. You've been believing God to heal you from a broken heart. You've been believing God to heal you from confusion. You've been believing God to bring your family back together again. And you're waiting and you're believing God. But God says your answer is in your mouth. It's in your mouth. Give it a name. Just like what the Bible says with Adam in the beginning. We see we have power in our mouth. We have dominion in our mouth. The Bible said that after God had created the fowls of the air and the creatures of the sea, the Bible says that God brought everything to Adam to see what he would call him. See, God is watching you. God is going to see what you're going to do. If you want to be blessed, if you want that new blessing, if you want that blessing that you've been waiting on God for, God is watching you. God is watching you to see what you're going to call it. And see, many people are stuck and many people are living up under a curse and fighting. It's like they're fighting against themselves because they've been opening up their mouth negatively. They've been titling sicknesses. They've been titling pain. You've been titling confusion. But don't do that. See, that's the devil. And see, what the devil will do, this is what he will do. He will cause you to look at your circumstances and he will get you to identify with your circumstances. And see, as long as you don't speak, that circumstance, that situation ain't going to overtake you. That situation ain't going to become strong. But the moment that you open up your mouth and call it what it is, then that's when it's going to form and become created. Because the Bible says that there's life and death in the power of your tongue. See, your victory is in your tongue. Your peace, the search is over. You've been dealing with what you've been dealing with. You've been fighting confusion, and it's been noisy around you late at night. When you go to sleep at night or when you lay down at night, that's when everything speaks up. Even in your midnight hour, even at late at night, don't allow your mind to speak to you. Don't allow your circumstances to speak to you. Don't allow your troubles to speak to you, because you can speak to your storm. Just like what Jesus did when that storm was boisterous, when the disciples had woke Jesus up. And Jesus looked at that storm and said, "Peace, be still." And so I come to tell you, give it a name, title it. If you want change, title your change. If you want victory, title your victory. If you want your family to come back together, title it. If you want your kids to act right, begin to speak it. Begin to speak it. For the Bible says, if you decree a thing, God said that I would hasten to perform it. Are you listening to me? Your change is in your mouth. And see, you've been waiting on God, but God has been waiting on you to give it a name. God's been waiting on you to give your storm a name. If you want your storm to end, if you want your storm to become calm, God wants you to give it a name. God wants you to speak peace to it right now. If you need healing in your body, and you know what you've been feeling with, but you've been talking about how sick you are. You've been talking about how you've been feeling. You've been talking about your emotions. You also been talking about how your heart has been broken. You keep talking about it. See, the thing about it, the more you talk about it, the more you're making it grow. But if you want it to die, see, word also cancels word. If you want stuff to cancel in your life, begin to title it. Even those that are fighting depression in your mind, the voices of depression been speaking to you. You need to give it a name. You need to speak to your depression. You need to speak to those suicidal voices. Those voices that are telling you that you're useless. Those voices that are telling you that you're going to be alone all your life. See, that's a liar. You need to learn how to tell the devil he's a liar. For the Bible says to resist the devil and he will flee. And the way that you can resist the devil is your mouth. See, your victory is in your mouth. And see, another thing that God has given you as a believer, has given us as those that have been shaped in his image, he's given us dominion. And that means to do. That means to overcome. That means to hold down. And see, those things that are trying to rise up in your life, troubles are trying to rise up in your life. Pains and people from your past that you don't want in your life are trying to rise up in your life. The Bible said, God said, it's time to rule it. It's time to subdue it. In other words, hold it down. It's time to speak against it. It's time to put it under your feet. And so if you want change, if you want something to happen, if you want your blessing, if you want what you've been praying for, if you want what you want to be believing God for to come to pass, give it a name and title it. Title your victory. Title your joy. Title your peace of mind. Title your destiny. Title, say, I am the head and not the tail. I'm blessed when I go in and I'm blessed when I come out. I'm healed by his stripes. I am healed. I am healed because he says so, by his stripes. And so I come to tell you in closing, learn how to title it. Give it a name. Amen. God bless you. Learn how to give it a name. And see, stop talking bad. Stop saying negative things, but begin to talk positive. And see, that's what the adversary is trying to use against you. And see, we don't walk by sight, but we walk by faith. The just shall live by faith. This is a faith walk. And the more you have faith with God, the more you have the power of God. The more you have the faith of God, the more you have the confidence of God. For the Bible says to not cast away your confidence. See, because in confidence, there is joy. In confidence is the voice of God. And see, God, what God wants you to do, God is bringing even some of you, bringing up out of you even a greater boldness. See, there's a boldness in you that wants to come out. There's a boldness in you that's trying to come out, but that boldness is waiting on you to give it a name. That boldness is waiting on you to title it. It's time. There's a new joy that's trying to jump up out of you. There's a new peace that is trying to jump up out of you, but it can't come until you recognize it, until you call it out, until you identify it, until you give it a name, until you title it. Amen. God bless you. God bless. Little quick thought to encourage you. And so you've been waiting on God, but God been waiting on you, just like what he told with Moses. He said, Moses, what is in your hand? And the very thing was in hand was the rod. That's the same rod that he had got when he was at the burning bush. That same rod from the beginning. That same rod that brought them out of Egypt. That same rod that brought them across the Red Sea. That same rod. God said, stretch out the rod. And that rod caused the Red Sea to open up. And see, when you begin to open up your mouth, When you begin to open up your mouth and speak against or speak to or title the very thing that you're asking God for, that situation is going to heap up. That situation is going to open up, and you're going to find yourself going over into the other side. You're going to find yourself going into your promised land. For this is the day that the Lord has made, and it's time to move forward. It's time to move forward now. It's time out for the devil running up the top and down the bottom, you in your mind, talking to your mind, keeping you down, holding you down. It's time to get up. It's time to arise. It's time to shake yourself. It's time to move forward. It's time to pursue. For the Bible said, God said that you shall recover all. It's time for you to get it back. It's time for you to embrace. It's time for you to walk back in order. It's time for your prayer life again. It's time for you to have joy again. It's time for your pocketbooks to have money again. It's time for your quiver to be full again. It's time for your blessing to come back into your house again. Amen. God bless you. Title it. Title it, title it, title it. Amen. God bless you. And God bless you. I got to go, but do me a favor. If this word has really blessed you, please share. But remember, give it a name. Title it. Because there's power in your mouth. There's authority in your mouth. And see, don't let the devil, don't let the adversary, don't let the circumstances of your life, don't let what you're facing, don't let what you're fighting keep you quiet. See, because the devil wants to shut you up. The devil wants you to be quiet. See, because what God is calling for in this day and time, God is raising up and God is calling out big mouths. God wants you to have a big mouth. It's time for you to stop being quiet and looking cute and sounding cute. For the Bible says to make a joyful noise, not a sad noise, but a joyful noise unto the Lord. And see, when you make a joyful noise unto the Lord, what's going to happen? The joy of the Lord is your strength. God's going to come. God's going to speak. And God is going to hasten to perform his word even in your mouth. Remember, give it a name. Title it. Amen. God bless you. And heaven smile on you. And may all God's best be yours. God bless you. Keep us in your prayers. Keep us in your prayers. Keep us in your prayers. God bless you. Amen. Amen. Woo!